Assalamu alaikum, dear students. In the previous lecture, I gave you a brief introduction about the tenses. Today, we are going to learn present tense and its forms. Present tense, as you know, it has four forms. Number first is simple present. Number second is present progressive, or we can say present continuous. Present continuous or present progressive. Number third is present perfect. And last is, number fourth is present perfect progressive or continuous tense. We can say present perfect progressive, or we can say present perfect continuous tense. Now let us take this present simple. So first, let us take this present simple. Here in present simple, number first, we use the helping verb. Helping verb, do or does. So in present simple or simple present, we use the helping verb do or does depending on the subject. Depending on the subject. Do, it is used with plural and I, when I is subject. Does is used with singular. Now I will take an example. He plays tennis. Now this sentence, this is affirmative sentence. This sentence is affirmative sentence. I will write here affirmative. Now I want to change this sentence into negative. I will write he is singular. I can write he does not play tennis. This is negative sentence. I can change this sentence into interrogative as well. I can write like this. Does he play tennis? And this is interrogative sentence. Now likewise, you can frame different sentences using different subjects. You can use I, you can use we, you can use you. So you can use different subjects and you can frame different sentences like affirmative sentence, negative sentence, interrogative sentence. Only you have to remember do is used with plural and does is used with singular. Now let us see the main verb. How main verb is used in simple present. We use main verb. Here in simple present, we use the first form of the main verb. First form of the verb. First form of the verb. And when the subject is singular, then at that very time, we have to add S or ES to verb. So when the subject is singular, singular subject, there must be subject verb agreement. That is why when the subject is singular, we add S or ES to verb. So these two things you have to remember. Now let's take where we use this simple present. What are the uses of the simple present? Different uses. Number first, universal truths. So whenever you will find a sentence that expresses universal truth, then you have to use simple present. For example, the sun rises in the east. Another, the earth move round the sun. So these are the two sentences which express universal truths. The sun rises in the east. The earth moves round the sun. This is the first use, important use. Number second is habitual activities. So we use this simple present when there are the sentences which express habitual activities. Now, number second is habitual activities. For example, I get up at 6 o'clock every day. Number second, he always come in time. Now, if you look at these two sentences, here in the first sentence we find this every day, in the second sentence we find this always, then we come to know that there is a mention of some habitual activity in these two sentences, and we use the simple present. So that this is the sentence which expresses habitual activity, and you should use this simple present. Now, adverbs of frequency are normally used in such sentences. Adverbs of frequency, like always, often, usually, generally, seldom, sometimes, every day, once a day, month, year, every morning. So whenever you find these adverbs of frequency, you should use this simple present. So I will write here, I get up at 6 o'clock every day. I get. He always comes in time. Now number third use is natural or inherent qualities or characteristics, which are inborn qualities. Now number third is natural, or we can say inherent qualities, or we can say characteristics. Number third use is natural or inherent qualities or characteristics. Here we also use simple present. For example, a mother love her children. This is the inborn quality. Every mother loves her children. So we can say a mother loves her children. A mother loves her children. Another, honey sweet. Here is the B. And you know, B when it is present is am or when past was and were. So here I can write honey is sweet. Now likewise, number fourth, permanent. Or nearly permanent activities. Permanent activities. Activities. That means these activities, permanent or nearly permanent activities, they are actually fixed activities. Or we can say they are regular activities. Regular activities. So whenever you find such a type of situation, permanent, nearly permanent activity or regular activity which are usually fixed, and you have to use this simple present. I will write here some examples. He go for a walk in the morning. Now this is fixed, regular. I can write, he goes for a walk in the morning. Another example, they play tennis in the afternoon. Now I can write here, they play tennis in the afternoon. They play. Now there are some other uses of this simple present, and we shall discuss them in next video. Thank you.